Odakle si?
Sa Tajlanda.
Divna kultura.
Znam ja jednu Turkinjicu.
Ko je gledao seriju Nečista krv, a svi su gledali, sigurno ste zapazili jednu devojku egzotičnog izgleda, kako glumi Redžepovicu. Ja sam saznala ko je ta devojka, tako da je danas upoznajem sa vama, a i vas sa njom. Hello, Nabi Tang.
Hi.
Hi, welcome to my show. Please introduce yourself to the people who maybe don't know who you are.
To which camera?
This one.
Okay. Hi, my name is Nabi. I am from Thailand and now I live here in Serbia. I moved here 4 years ago with my son and now I live with 3 cats as well.
Great. Tell me, what do you do for a living, like here?
I am a photographer. Actually, I am a stock photographer. I mean, I work online. I have a stock portfolio, which I take my own picture and then I sell it. And I decide to move here because I have a son, which is half Serbian, but I divorced with his father. And I don't want him to forget the language, you know. And I like the education system here, so I decide to move here.
That's nice. And did you learn some Serbian?
I try to learn. I should learn, but because of the language is so far different from Thai, so I gave up. I am sorry, but because most of the friends that I know and people that I work with speak English, and my son is my personal translator, so that make me like less active in that.
Mm-hmm. So your son, he speaks Serbian?
He speaks Serbian, yeah. Wow. He speaks Thai, he speaks English, and he speaks Serbian.
Okay. I would like to talk some more about Nečista krv, Impure Blood. How did you got the role there, since you say you are a photographer here?
Okay. Well, I mean, I know a lot of friends that are photographers here also, and sometimes they would call me for the shoot, or like some of my friends that are designer call me to model for their brand, and I've been doing that as well. And I have two films before Nečista krv that I was an actress, and the second film was showing in Polish, yeah, at the Dead Lake Film Festival, and I met one person there that he saw the film, and he became my friend, and then he worked with this production, and he called me to come for the casting, and that's a story. It's just happened.
And as far as I could notice, in this TV show, you are speaking Turkish a bit.
Yes.
Was it difficult?
It's very difficult, as you know. If Serbian and English is already difficult for me, Turkish is like out of this world. I don't know. But I have just few lines, and I have few months to practice, so that's
fair enough.
That's okay.
Fair enough, yeah, that's okay. So you are from Thailand, and it must be very exotic for you to participate in this kind of story and to learn so much about our history, our customs, our whatever, family relations. So what was your impression by doing this show? Could you understand, you know, the whole tradition about it?
Well, I can't understand the whole tradition just from one series, but I do know the story a little bit, and I also find that there are some similarity to my culture and my custom tradition in the past as Asian, you know, like in the past, in that era, in that time, like a woman don't have much choice in their life and they cannot make decision for their future. So she pretty much depend on her family. And in Thailand, we have like the woman is like a property, actually. Possession of the father or a husband, you know, which they can keep.
Ništo, mi snimamo ovdje, uspeli ste da uđete u snimak na pravom trenutku. Šalim se, nema problema.
Odakle si?
Sa Tajlanda.
Divna kultura, divna.
Beautiful culture, he says.
At that era, at that time, like in Thailand, few hundred years ago, and also like China, because my family are Chinese, and so the woman pretty much born and being raised for some purpose to serve the man, so she doesn't have her own choice. She's not born to be heard her opinion, you know. She just have to take care of the family, raise the child, and for few hundred years ago, women are property of the father, so her father can sell her to be a slave or can sell her to a rich, wealthy person, and then she cannot say no, you know.
That's no is not an option.
Yeah,
yeah, unfortunately. Yeah. So what is your impression by participating in this kind of story? Do you think that Serbians were savages in the past?
Everyone is savages in the past, you know. We are evolving. My country also have some, you know, thing that was not, I mean, there's something that is not acceptable at this time. And when we look back, the past are more savage, and as we evolve, you know, we change. Yeah. So I do not think that Serbia is savage.
What do you think about women's rights in your country, in Thailand? Has the situation changed? Is it better? Some things are better?
Maybe. Yeah, it's getting better. I mean, because internet and social media and a lot of new generation are more educated now, so they are raising this awareness.
And marriages that are made because of the money, do they still exist?
Unfortunately, yes, it still exists.
Okay, okay. You can tell us something about your character, Recepovica. How did you understand her? What do you think about her?
Oh, well, from the beginning, I have so little information about this. I only given the script, and it's very short, but Goran have explained to me. And at the beginning, I was confusing. Why do I get this role, you know? Because obviously, 10 years ago, I don't see Asian here in this city center. Mm-hmm. And then like 100 years ago, or I don't know how long, how can she show up here? But I guess that maybe her husband, Richard, he probably travel a lot, and he's a powerful, wealthy man. He probably found her on the way during his trip, and maybe he bought her from her parents when she was young, and she is now living a comfortable life with him. But then she risked her life and her everything to have an affair with a stranger. This is what I find it interesting. How can someone be that desperate, you know? But I think that it could be because of her, at the age that she need to explore her sexuality, and maybe also because she craving for freedom, like any form of freedom that she can do anything she want, and that's how she end up doing this crime, you know.
It's a very good explanation. You made it clear for me now. Thank you. Of course. And okay, let's talk about your life here in Serbia. Have you learned some Serbian words? I know you haven't learned Serbian, but some words.
Yeah.
What do you use on an everyday basis?
Well, I use ne razumem. When someone asks me, do you know Serbian? And I just say ne razumem or malo. And I know name of different things, you know, like water and name of vegetable or fruit, and I know how to say lepospawa, something like this, you know, the thing that I use with my son and my ex-boyfriend.
Okay, I understand. Great. And what about Serbian food? What do you like here?
Actually, me and my son, we mostly eat vegetarian, and that's very difficult to live here for vegetarian. I'm a little bit more flexible. I can eat fish, but we love ajvar. We love to eat ajvar and all the Serbian pickle, tomato juice, and I love smoked trout. Trout, fish, river fish, trout.
Yeah, pastrmka, ja mislim da je to.
Yeah, I trout. Love it. And the salad with the cheese, I think it's kaimak, I believe.
Salad with cheese, yeah, shopska, salata.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I forget the name, but there was paprika, tomato.
Yeah.
And I love vegetable and fruit here the most, you know. It tastes the best in Serbia.
Yeah, still it does, I know. What about our drinks? Have you tried rakia?
I know you're gonna ask me about that. I do not really drink alcohol, but I do try some rakia, and my favorite one is peach rakia.
No, a peach.
Yeah.
Okay, breskva, but I didn't know we have breskva rakija, rakija od breskve. Okay.
I tried that.
And you're very.
It smells really beautiful.
Okay.
But I commonly just see with the plum.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sure. That's...
But the peach is the most impressive one.
Mm. Okay, and what about the social life here? Do you like going to Kafana for lunch, for meeting up with people?
I mean, there is not much thing that I like to eat in Kafana, you know. And, and I am sensitive to alcohol and sensitive to caffeine, so I don't go much often to Kafana. And in Thailand, people like to drink ice drink, you know, and Kafana doesn't really serve like chocolate with ice or tea with ice, which Thai people just love ice. And but then I just more like stay at home, cooking at home, and I invite my friend over, or I go to my friend's place, and then we cook.
Okay, nice. And how did the people here accepted you? You know what I mean. How do they react when they see you in the street? Because, okay, strangers here, they became common,
yeah.
But still, how do people in general react?
Well, now they just pass me by. They don't stop to say hello. Randomly, sometimes some people are konnichiwa to me or ni hao to me. They think I'm Japanese or Chinese. But people treat me well here. But 10 years ago, when I came here, it was more interesting because everyone are staring at me and everyone are like wanting to ask me question, what are you doing here? Why are you here? You know. But now there are a lot of Asian people in this area.
Yeah, do you have, like, not a problem, but do you have often situations that people want to be too close to you because they're too friendly? I mean, like, for example, this old gentleman who passed right next to us, he was, oh, you're so nice, can I pat your head?
But I have usually old people are very sweet to me. I don't mind. I feel like they welcome me. They want to make sure that everything is okay. Make me feel like home, which I appreciate. Like when I go to a piazza market also, they always like, oh, you can have extra garlic. Or you want apple, you know, give me extra something. And usually old people are so sweet here. But I also have sometimes some people approach me, not such a nice way too, but that's rarely happened to me, you know, just during Corona time that I feel like I shouldn't go out.
Yeah, Corona was a nasty period. Yeah.
Yeah.
I know. Okay.
Yeah, but the rest is fine. Totally. People here are sweet to me.
Mm-hmm. I would like to know, what do you think, how are Serbian men? Are they nice to women? Do they have like a friendly attitude, or they can sometimes be pushy.
Okay, so Serbian men are very different than Asian men, because Asian men, they are more like feminine, let's say.
Okay.
I think they are more gentle when they speak also, and they approach women more soft. But the Serbian men, they approach women with confidence. And they are more like they are boss. Yeah, they act like they are boss, you know. And they are not having this gesture like the rest of the men in Europe that open the door for women and things like this, you know. But I feel like they are more family. They give a comfort, a family feeling, you know, stability, you know, this kind of support.
What about Serbian women? Because usually strangers, strange men who came here, they say Serbian women are very pretty.
Yes, a lot of beautiful model here. And like when I go to the bus or when I walk on the street, I see beautiful women all the time. Like many people could be like serious model professionally, you know, on the street, everywhere.
Okay. Thank you very much. You're so nice. And I hope you didn't feel any kind of pressure during the interview, because, you know, everything was so spontaneous and I really liked it.
I'm happy about that.